Hello, this is Christina Long, and this is the Science 411. Today's video is over combining equilibrium expressions. This is the second video in this series for equilibrium. The first video was writing equilibrium expressions, and today we're talking about combining them. So in the case where you have two or more expressions that you have to combine, you're going to do it in a similar fashion to what you do in algebra as far as combining or adding algebraic equations, or more commonly, or what you should be more used to in this class, which would be Hess's law, what we did in thermochemistry. So it is similar to Hess's law, but it has some notable differences. Number one, the first one is that you're finding for Kc, or your equilibrium constant, not for delta H. If you reverse the reaction when you're combining equilibrium expressions, what you're going to do with the numbers, you're going to make it a reciprocal. If you multiply the reaction, then you're going to use an exponent. If you divide, you're going to take the root of. And then when you finally get all your stuff together, when you combine your reactions, you're going to multiply rather than add. So let's go ahead and get started on some of these practice problems. Okay, in this first reaction, you've got 2HF added to C2O4, negative 2 charge, and it's going to yield 2F negative plus H2C2O4. The first thing you need to do is look and see if you can use all of the pieces there, and you can. They're all aqueous. Then you've got your two equations underneath, and I do this a very certain way. You don't have to do it the same way I do it, but I'm going to show you my way. I'm looking at my reactants, and I'm looking at the reactant that I'm trying to get to, and I need 2HF. Well, I've got HF that shows up together on the reactant side, but it doesn't have enough. So it's on the right side, it doesn't have enough, so what am I going to end up doing? I'm going to end up multiplying that equation by 2. And I'm going to leave that alone for right now. The next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go and I'm going to look at that very last piece, that very last product, that H2C2O4. That's unusual enough to where it's easy to pick out. I obviously need that on the product side. It's not found in the first equation, but it is found in the second equation. And it is the correct number, but it's on the wrong side, so I'm going to have to reverse that equation. So I have a plan of what it is I'm going to do, so I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to do that. So I'm going to change things around. I am going to multiply everything by 2, and because I multiplied everything by 2, remember that instead of just multiplying my Kc value by 2, instead I'm going to put a 2 as an exponent. So I'm going to end up squaring that number. And then my other one, my last piece, is I have to reverse the second equation. And so I'm going to go ahead and do that. And in doing that, I'm going to have 2H plus, forgive me for not writing the states of matter, but I'm going to try and do it kind of quickly, C2O4, negative 2, and then I've got my H2C2O4 on the correct side. So I have everything on the correct side, but remember, because I reversed the reaction, I need to make that number a reciprocal, so I'm going to throw that under a 1 and make that my reciprocal. The next thing I need to do when I'm combining these things is remember, I need 2HF. I have 2HF there. I need a C2O4 with a negative 2, C2O4 with a negative 2, a 2F negative, 2F negative, and then my H2C2O4, H2C2O4. I have everything that I need. I have some extra stuff in there that, because it's on opposite sides of the equation, I can cross-cancel. So I can cross-cancel that stuff. So now I'm looking at my values at the end of it. So basically I'm going to take 6.8 times 10 to the negative 4, and I'm going to need to square that for that first Kc value. And then I'm going to multiply that by my 1 over 3.8 times 10 to the negative 6. And I'm going to put that where you can actually read it. I'm going to multiply it by 1 over 3.8 times 10 to the negative 6. And when I do that, my answer should come out to be 0.12. And that's my KC value. And remember, my KC value, it doesn't have a unit. It didn't have a unit going into the problem, and it doesn't have a unit leaving the problem. So that is your final answer for that first example problem. So for this next equation, you've got 2 moles of HNN3, and then you're going to, you know what? It's not HN3. I thought it looked wrong. It should be NH3. That would make a lot more sense. There we go. We have 2 moles of NH3 gas added to 3 moles of diatomic iodine gas, and it's going to yield 6 moles of HI gas and 1 mole of N2 gas. And then you've got your two equations underneath. Each of them has a KC value. So yet again, I'm going to start with what I need, and I need 2 moles of NH3. NH3 does not show up in the first equation, but it does show up in the second equation. It shows up this correct number, but it's on the wrong side. So I'm going to end up having to reverse that second equation. And, you know, I'm going to skip the iodine. I'm going to go over to that product side, and I'm going to look at that 6HI. I need 6, and I need it on the product side. Now, in that first equation, that HI is on the product side, but there's only 2. So what I'm going to end up having to do is I'm going to end up having to multiply that first equation by 3. So we're going to go ahead and do all that. So the first part, I'm going to have my 3H2 and then my 3I2. And instead of having my 2HI, now I'm going to have 6. And because I multiplied the entire equation by 3, then that means I'm going to have to cube that value. And we're going to have to reverse the other one, the second equation. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to do that. So now I've got my 10, or my 2NH3. And it's going to yield N2 and 3H2 gas. And because I reversed it, I need to put that as a reciprocal, so I put it under 1. And now we're going to go and evaluate what we've got and see if we have what we need. I have 2NH3. I have 2NH3. 3I2, 3I2, 6HI, 6HI, an N2, and an N2. And we do have those outliers. They match, they're on opposite sides of the equation, so I can cross-cancel. So then with my values, I've got everything set up the way it needs to be. So I'm going to have my 54 cubed, and it's going to be multiplied. Once you get that answer, you're going to multiply it by the value of 1 over 1.004 times 10 to the negative 4. And when you do that, your answer should be 1.51. Let's put that where you can read it. 1.51 times 10 to the 9th. And that should give you your answer. So, all in all, you've got two practice problems with combining them. And if you'll remember that, similar to Hess's law, you're going to multiply when you finally get your numbers. But if you multiply your equation, you're going to have to take that number and make it an exponent. If you divide, you're going to have to take the square root. And then if you reverse it, you're going to make it a reciprocal. And again, once you get all your numbers, you are going to multiply them all together. So I hope this was helpful. For those of you that are watching this for a class, go to your discussion piece on Canvas and leave a comment there for me. Otherwise, I hope this was helpful for you. I miss you guys. And remember to make good choices and clean your room. Have a good one.